To stand up, let's all stand up for to pray for the word of God. I request the man of God, the pastor, the servant of God that is sharing the word to come forward so that we can pray to him. Thank you, Jesus, for your word. Your word is sharper than a double-edged sword, O God. Your word is alive and active. Your word is like a hammer. And it crashed hard rocks. I thank you for your word. Right now, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, as you servant, stand and speak your word. I pray that God, may your word proceed also from his mouth. I pray right now that you start whispering to his ears, that he can speak it aloud to us, oh God, that we can hear exactly what you want us to hear. Oh God, you don't gather your people just in vain, and therefore we know that you have a portion for each and every one of us. We pray, oh God, let your word come. We pray that God, you help us to accept it as our word today. For we pray this, trusting and believing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Let's get seated in the presence of God. My name is Pastor John Wachira of Christ is the Answer Church in North Chelmsford here in Massachusetts. I want to thank God for all of us who are gathered here to celebrate the good works that our God has helped our sister Anne, Mrs. Bishop Kehato, to do. Now, I'd like to share with you very briefly a testimony that was given by our brother Peter in the book of Acts chapter 13 and verses 36. Acts chapter 13 and verses 36. Acts 13 verses 36. The Bible says, we're getting there. The Bible says, for when David had served God's purpose in his own generation, he fell asleep, he was buried with his fathers, and his body decayed. But the one whom God raised from the dead did not see decay. Amen. This is a cut from the scripture, from a long portion of scripture. But I want you to listen to these words. That after David had served his generation according to the will of God, he fell asleep and he faced decay. I want to bring it to you that whenever we come to this life, God always, all of us, God prepares us to serve our generation. Not according to our will, but according to the will of God. This man called David, David was not a special being. David was a man like you and I. But David chose to rest his life in the hands of God. David chose to give himself fully to God. And after David giving himself fully, he became a vessel in the hand of God. And once a person becomes a vessel in the hand of God, regardless of their education, regardless of their background, they become a force to the economy. Today we are here to celebrate because one of us has surrendered to God and has said, I want to be a vessel in the hands of my master. I want to be a vessel in the hands of my God. David chose. David was not special in any way. David was exactly like any one of us. Yes. David had a lot of shortcomings. David had a lot of weaknesses. David, there are a lot of records in the Bible about many areas, not one, many areas where David fell short of the will of God. But David was a man who every time was looking forward to be used by God. Every time he was we can do, used by God. I want to bring it to you. Whenever you see a person, and look at the person next to you, just look at them right on their faces. Look at that person next to you, with my permission. With my permission, you may be, maybe you don't know them, but just look at them. Tell them you can be used by God. Oh, tell them confidently, you can be used by God. Tell them you are the kind that God uses. David was used by God because he availed himself to be used by God. And God can do anything to a man or a woman who is willing to surrender to him. Bible in the book of Ezekiel chapter 37, and because of time I'm not going to read, I'll just paraphrase it. This man of God called Ezekiel, Bible says he was taken to a valley full of dry bones. And Bible says the valley was full of very dry bones. And God asked Ezekiel, son of man, can these bones live again? And Ezekiel answered God, I don't know, but only you, God, who knows. And God told Ezekiel to prophesy to those dry bones. And Bible says, after Ezekiel prophesied to the bones, God infused life to the very dry bones. Bones that were of no use. Bones that were completely dead. Thank God you are alive, and you are well, and you are kicking. These were dry bones. And the bones were very dry, Bible says. But after God infusing life, after God and tell God, I want to serve my generation, because the power to serve my generation, it is not with the people. The power to serve my generation, it is not given of my friends. It is given by God. Amen. And all that you need to do, it is to surrender to God. And tell God, here I am. I am a willing vessel to be used of you. If Anne would open her heart to you and give you her story. She was not born a singer. Hear me today. Anne was not born a singer. These men clad in suits and nice cat suits. They were not born pastors and bishops and evangelists. No. They were born regular, ordinary people. Yes. But they availed themselves in the hand of the Master. Because the moment you avail yourself in the hand of the Master, you become of use.
Yes.
You become a vessel of honor. Amen. And today, they serve us and they serve our community so well because they have availed themselves in the hands of the Master.
Hallelujah.
This afternoon, I want to challenge you to avail yourself in the hands of the Master. The last 30 years, I've been serving the Lord. And I've come to realize God is not looking for certain vessels. God uses any vessel that is available before Him.
Amen.
And let me tell you, the person next to you can surprise you.
Yes.
They can become something you never dreamt they can become.
Yes.
As long as they are in the hands of the Master.
Amen.
If the bone of a jaw of a donkey, a dead donkey, can kill thousands. Hallelujah. How much more can you do? And you are alive and you are bigger than a Job of a donkey. Praise the name of the Lord. How much more can you do? And you are not a dead, dry bone. Praise the name of the Lord. All that you need to do is to avail yourself. And this is very personal. In the hands of the Master. And you told the master, Master, infuse life in me. Yeah. Let me tell you, the moment the master infuses life in you, you become an instrument that can be of use and you serve your generation like David did.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Somebody give God praise.
Hallelujah.
I want to thank God for what He is doing. You see, Sister Anne, that today Anne, even while she was asleep,
yes,
when her time of exiting this world comes, she will leave something that the generation that will be left can hang on.
Yes.
She will leave her music that she's written,
uh-huh,
that the generation that will come after her, they can hang on that.
Yes.
And they can thank God on that. Praise the name of the Lord. Yes. And you, and you, and you, and you, and even I, we can do something. The same God who has blessed Anne so much, He's able to bless you.
Yes.
Probably you'll be a singer, but you can write a book. Probably you cannot write a book, but you can be a Sunday school teacher.
Yes.
Probably you cannot be a Sunday school teacher, but you can make your church better than it is. You can add value in the house of God.
Hallelujah.
All of us, we have got potential to be used by God. All that you need to do is to avail yourself like David did.
Yes.
David became a mighty warrior in Israel. Not because he was born a warrior, no. David was born a regular, ordinary Jewish boy. But he availed himself in the hand of the Savior. This evening I want to challenge you, avail yourself. How do I avail myself, Pastor? You avail yourself in prayer. And you start with the first step, giving your life to Jesus. If you have never given your life to Jesus.
Yes.
After you give your life to Jesus, avail yourself to follow and to study and to this word of God. After that, avail yourself in the place of prayer. I call it the place of power. Praise the name of the Lord. Any person who prays and talks to God, hallelujah, they are able to deliver victory. You know, when David was challenged by Goliath, he told Goliath, "You are coming with a javelin, but I am coming in the name of my God, in whose army you have been found." Praise the name of the Lord. The name of the Lord was a weapon in the life of David. Because David had availed himself before God.
Yes.
I challenge you today, avail yourself before God. You will do wonders, not in the next generation, in our generation.
Amen.
I say you are a candidate of doing wonders in our generation.
Amen.
Because the power to do wonders is not with men, it is with God. If God votes you, no one can vote you out.
Yes.
If men vote you, they can vote you out. God today is willing to vote you in. But you need to avail yourself. You need to tell the Lord, come into my heart. I want to serve my generation. I want to do a thing that I've never done. And if you are able to raise out of dry bones an army, my God, you can do wonders using me. Praise the name of the Lord. I say God can do wonders using you. I say God can do something using you. All that you need to do is to avail yourself before
Hallelujah.
God. And as you avail yourself before God in prayer, telling God, touch my life. Even your family can do what?
Amen.
Your children can do what? Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
One time, I decided I would try. As a minister of the gospel, I said I've done many things in life. This time around, I want to try business. And I tried it. Were there challenges? Yes. Well, there are people who are telling me, Pastor, you cannot do that. Yes. But I have heard the voice of the Lord.
Yes.
But let me tell you, God did wonders. And God today can do wonders in your life.
Yes.
He's always looking for a person who will say, Lord, I will believe you and stand.
Amen.
And when you stand in God, God will do wonders in you.
Yes.
Let us stand up that you may pray. Our Father, we want to thank you.
Yes, Father.
Master, we know that you are faithful.
Yes.
Master, we know that you are ready.
Hallelujah.
My Father, when you are in your hands, you are able to turn around things that look impossible and you make them possible.
Amen.
Because it is you who started a good work in our lives. Father, there are people who are seated here, and they have got issues with their family. And those issues are hurting them every day. And today, because they are vessels in your hands, I pray that you turn their lives around. There are people who are seated here, Lord. And Father, they have got gifting in them. And Master, you want to use them to change our generation. Just like David changed his generation. I pray that you help them to rise. I pray that you help them to surrender to you. That you may use them for your glory. Father, I want to thank you. For there are people who are here. They don't know how to start. And I want to thank you because the first journey starts with you.
Yes,
start by one surrendering to you.
Yes.
And getting to know you as the Lord and Savior.
Hallelujah.
Father, reveal yourself to those that are not born again in our midst.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Every head is bowed down. Let's reduce that music a little bit. These are very, very important moments.